for the people who did not see it yet, the studio director of ESO did publish today a letter, which you can find on the ESO website. And it's called Studio's Director's Letter, ESO 2022 Retrospective and the Future. So as we approach the end of 2022, it's once again time to share some thoughts on where ESO is and to look ahead and what is to store for the game in the new year. In 2023, ESO will see an amazing chapter as well as some long requested changes to the types of the content that we will deliver based largely on community feedback. But before we get into all the details, 2022 is ending as we wind down the legacy of Threatens storyline. We were happy to welcome millions of new ESO players who joined over the course of 2022, which featured two new localizations, Spanish and simplified Chinese. We returned to live in-person events with another amazing and fun ESO Tavern in Germany this August. It was a great year, and even better in that we got start to travel again and seeing you all in person. I would be remiss if I didn't talk about the issues with the update 36, which launched just this last November. It introduced far too many bugs and issues, and even as I write this, we are still chasing down issues with blocking in combat. Trust me, I'm just as concerned about this as you all are. And we'll be making some process changes within the dev team to ensure that things like this happen far more rarely. With an aging code base, which is 26 million lines of code, really, it is difficult to be 100% efficient, but we can be far, far better, and we know it. So, ESO looking forward. In general, there are two types of content in ESO. Handcrafted, such as quests, stories, and things you do one time per character, and systems, which are activities that are generally repeatable, such as PvP, dungeons, trials, housing, daily crafting rids, etc. We've always had a mix of two types of content, but in terms of dev team hours, the majority of time developing the game has been weighted towards questing content. As I mentioned above, the big news for 2023 is that based in significant part of player feedback, we are now at a point where we are reassessing the balance of handcrafted one and done storytelling content versus repeatable game activities. ESO is a massive game, with a huge number of zones, quests and systems. We have created 40 or so hours of hand-built content every year since 2015, as well as a myriad of dungeons and new systems like Fontamriel, Thieving, Assassinations, Companions, Tales of Tribute, Antiquities, Crafting Rids, Housing, graphical character customizations, solo and group arenas, PvP battlegrounds, and much more. Now that we have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours of questing content, enough for 4 or 5 regular RPGs, we are hearing from our new players that the sheer number of zones and stories and characters is intimidating. Yeah. And on the other hand, our veteran players consistently tell us that they would like more content that isn't played through just once. They would like more content they can enjoy for years. Content that utilizes our already existing zones to add new things to do, and most importantly, introduces some new gameplay. So overall, I will just now maybe just say something in between. I think that sounds already really, really good. That they, you know, rethinking the system, what they want to do. But yeah, let's go to the text and then we can discuss about the topic. So, moving forward to 23. Given the above, 2023 will see us moving away from the year-long adventure, 12-month storylines that we have featured since 2019 Season of the Dragon. I think many people will be happy about it. I think these have run their course and frees us up to do some new and interesting content that we've been wanting to do for a few years now. Let us return to expansive story arcs that unfold over multiple chapters. This year-long strategy was a huge success and raised the profile of ESO. But now, after 4 straight years, we are finding more and more that this cadence limits what we can do. So below is the 23 content cadence. Do you say cadence? I'm not sure. However you say it. Content for next year. Punkt. Please note that the first half of the year remains essentially unchanged, but the second half of the year now has an update devoted to addressing issues, quality of life improvements, and an update devoted to largely new tenth pole system. What's a tenth pole? A tent is what you do outside, right? And a pole is to hold a tent. Yeah, okay. I don't know what a tenth pole system is. Okay, but quarter one, we get the regular dungeon DLC. Quarter two, full feature chapter in June. The 23 ESO chapter will be a complete story. We'll be able to play all the way through it without a storyline that is broken out and reserved for later in the year. We will return to larger, better, and more detailed chapters by doing this. We are really excited about the next year's chapter. For details, we have to wait for our global reveal event in January. But one hint, this will be part of a multi-year story arc and will be contain one of the most requested new features. What is the most requested new feature, guys? And it will contain one of the most requested new features. I don't know. Free craft bag. Free craft bag, that would be amazing, but I doubt it. I mean, that would take away all the money from the ESO Plus. That's probably not the case. Okay, quarter three, focus on quality of life improvements and bug fixes. That's good. I mean, many people are saying that they want that ESO stops to put out more content, that they focus on improving the system. Because, you know, they're not... Depends what you do, you know, what kind of part you play in the game. Also, when you... I hear, for example, there are often bugs in trials. We know that in Zero Deal, PvP, not everything is going smooth. There's now also bug this block fix and, you know, some other bugs maybe... which could be better. And quality of life improvements is always good. Always. In quarter four, rather than the usual zone DLC, we'll be featuring a new system. It's not interesting. The question is, usually we had always the big new thing with the chapter. Like a new, you know, new skill line, new class, or... new system, whatever, antiquities, blah, blah, blah. But if they now say quarter four, we get a new system, maybe they take it out from the chapter and the chapter is just chapter and the new system is in quarter four. Maybe. I don't know. That's now a good question. We are working on the concept and design for this now. We'll give more details during the global reveal event. Now it's interesting to know. Also, it seems, sounds a bit short, oder? When they now think about what they want to do in quarter four, it's a year, but I don't know. A year can't be, can you know, it's not so long, or for a big game. So looking back at ESO evolution since 2014, you can see that we often shake things up, try new things, and make changes as needed. So we assess how this new cadence... Wait, how do you say that? Cadence. Okay. How this new cadence is received, both by the development team and in the community. So if we have to make more adjustments, we will. Okay. Also, for me, so until now, the text sounds really promising. Depends also a bit what they will announce then, you know, in January. But overall, if they maybe slow down, I also think it's not necessary that they push out twice a year dungeons. Maybe, but I also don't do so much dungeons anymore, so maybe I'm also not the right, right part of the community to judge about it. Is it enough or not? But overall, if they want to work on the content they already have, the existing content, and want to improve it and add stuff, I think that's like, you know, a good idea. And if they maybe can add more quality of life stuff from add-ons and stuff, or also, you know, for people who don't use add-ons or people who are on consoles, I also think that's fantastic. Also overall, I think that's a great idea. And I'm looking forward to the announcement then. It sounds, also overall, yeah, sounds good. About these hardware and server updates. We are in the home stretch of upgrading and replacing all ESO data center hardware, which of course has been significantly delayed by the ongoing global slowdown of sourcing computer hardware. Once complete, ESO servers and infrastructure will be much more reliable, and as we saw from the one realm that has been upgraded so far, PC NA, there will be some performance improvements as well. Yeah, that's what many people said. Later on, PvP in Cyrodiil was better. Almost all the hardware should be delivered and in place by December. And then we will need a month or two to install and test everything before we shift over to the new hardware. Please note that we'll be prioritizing all three realms in the EU data center first, and then we will turn to the NA data center to finish moving Xbox and PlayStation realms there. We are as frustrated as you that this has taken so long, but it is happening and will be done and ready for all players. Probably in late February or March of 2023. Our multi-threading work continues, and we announced a month or so back. Just to remind everyone, this is the initiative that will result in better overall server performance. As we already announced, we will be phasing these changes in over the course of 2023, starting with the chapter in quarter 2. We'll keep everyone updated and patch notes going forward. ESO fan gatherings in 2023. We've wanted to have a mass gathering of ESO fans in North America for years. And I'm very happy to say that we'll have having an in-person gathering this spring somewhere in the United States. Stay tuned for details, but you can expect to get hands-on with the new chapter, see presentations from the dev and community teams, and of course spend some time with fellow ESO players. We are definitely looking forward to seeing you North American fans in person. And of course we will see our European community again in summer as at the ESO Tavern. Stay tuned for details on that as well. As you can see, we've got some big plans for the future of ESO, and we can't wait to share more about what is coming to Tamriel in 2023 and beyond. As always, my heartfelt thanks to the ESO community for their role in the continued evolution of the Elder Scrolls Online. Your passion for the game, including its world and stories, is inspiring to us as developers, and we believe that Tamriel is in the second era wouldn't be the same without you or you. Without your own characters, communities, and yes, feedback. Here's another exciting year for the Elder Scrolls Online. See you in Tamriel. So. But yeah, so overall, I think this is a nice letter. It's open, it's well drafted. I think they thought really good about their wording. It's like, really? but I think it's a nice start. There's lots of things you can look forward to, some changes, maybe some improvements, technical improvements which take a bit time, but I think long term that's really necessary and will help. I hope it will really help in PvP, also on EU, because that will, I know that many people are really sad there, so I hope that will make it better, but we will see. I don't know. Also, we can't say for now. I think it sounds really positive, but we will learn more. What did you say in January? Will the global reveal event? So I guess they will maybe give us more dedicated data and a more official information. I assume usually directly after the reveal event, we have the PTS updated, as a public test server, and then we can test out stuff and see more. So yeah, but overall, I think for me at least, my opinion is, after I read the letter now, it sounds promising. And yeah, let's see how that goes.